Coming up tonight, the latest on the three tourists found dead in their Exuma hotel rooms. Plus, heartbroken, the son of one of the victims speaks. And later, why fuel prices are likely to remain high. A very special happy Mother's Day and welcome to our news weekend edition. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Megan Shepherd. The formal identification of the three tourists found dead at the luxury Sandals Resort on Emerald Bay, Exuma is being expedited. This latest news coming from Acting Prime Minister and Exuma MP Chester Cooper. In a statement today, Cooper saying the Royal Bahamas Police Force, the Ministries of Tourism and Health and Wellness, and U.S. Embassy officials have been working together from Saturday to expedite the process, which will make way for pathologists to begin autopsies to determine the exact cause of death. Cooper also saying in that statement that Prime Minister Davis has been kept abreast of the situation and that further updates will be provided once more information is available. The acting Prime Minister also reaching out personally to the families to offer condolences and prayers on behalf of the people of Exuma and the Bahamas. Both the Ministry of Tourism and the Royal Bahamas Police Force are expected to remain in close contact with the families of the deceased, Cooper asking for their privacy to be respected. The son of one of the tourists who lost their lives is speaking with ABC News, saying he is heartbroken. Austin Chilarella telling ABC that his father, Vincent, was everything to him. Vincent and his wife, Donis, were reportedly staying at the resort for their anniversary. Austin, who told ABC that he learned of the incident when the U.S. Embassy called him Friday night, says his mother, Donis, was the woman flown to the hospital. ABC reporting that she was airlifted to Kendall Regional Facility in Florida. Austin also telling ABC News that Donis told him she fell ill Thursday, but felt she was all right after leaving the clinic. This is a developing story that we will continue to follow. And for all of the latest on this and other top stories, visit Our News Bahamas on Facebook. In other news tonight, oil prices are likely to remain high as supply is likely to remain a challenge due to the war in Ukraine. Rising inflation will also push prices up, according to Fidelity CEO Goin Bo.
For those excess reserves that the United States may have, that the Arabic countries may have, they will, as oil-producing countries, OPEC, they are really going, they're in the driver's seat because as oil producers, they can dictate the price, and as supply is limited, they can sell to the highest bidder. So I think we're going to continue to see price rises because until the world supply of oil returns to normalcy following this conflict resolution, we're going to have excess demand over supply, and so we're going to see prices continue to rise.
Petroleum retailers have warned that the price of gas at the pump could hit $7 sometime in May. They've also warned that prices could ultimately get as high as $8 per gallon. As it stands, the major retailers in New Providence are hovering around $6.30 per gallon on average.
That means that we as a population in the Bahamas, unfortunately, don't have much control over that because we are importers. We don't produce. And so from that perspective, we are simply importing the global price. And that means that each of us has to look in the mirror and say, what can we do to limit our consumption? If we have a finite amount of money to spend, it means that instead of spending the same amount of money that would get us more fuel in the past, we have the same amount of money that's going to get us less fuel, and it's more about a reprioritization of how we spend it.
Speaking of rising fuel prices, Prime Minister Philip Davis traveling to Middle Tennessee State University this weekend to deliver a commencement speech to hundreds of graduates, in which he addressed the issue, speaking about the world we live in now.
We are seeing too, you and I, how a war half world away can impact our everyday lives. The conflict in Eastern Europe means higher prices for all of us and a new shape to the energy landscape and an outcome that will affect geopolitics in ways we can't imagine and ways we cannot.
Asking graduates to consider the world we now live in, the Prime Minister telling graduates that they have much more in common than they might think and encourage them on the road ahead.
Many of you are here about to start new jobs. And I just started a new job too, 7 or so months ago, when my party won the general elections in the Bahamas and I became the Prime Minister. And just like you, I'm confronting challenges that seem to grow more complex by the day.
And still to come on our news, the Education Minister talks next steps as it's back to face-to-face learning soon. Plus, the passing of the baton, the head of the National Trust gets ready to step down. And happy Mother's Day from Rev and Alive. That's coming up when our news returns.
My name is Augustine Roberts, and my mother is Verona Roberts. She is the apple of my eye. She has had my back from day one. I'd like to send a happy and a special Mother's Day to her. And I encourage everyone to cherish their mothers. And all the mothers of Alive and Cable Bahamas, I would like to say a special happy Mother's Day to you, and God bless.
Mosquitoes becoming an issue? Struckum Commercial Pest Services is the number one service provider for vanquishing those annoying bugs. Mosquitoes are more than a nuisance. They're also a health risk, transmitting diseases including malaria, dengue fever, and even the West Nile virus. With accredited verified training and technology, Struckum will deal with the conditions that invite mosquitoes, tackle current infestations, and stop their life cycle, therefore reducing the number of mosquitoes on your corporate property. Struckum, number one in pest control services.
Clean, sleek, modern. Conet Bahamas introduces their Casablanca all-white shaker cabinets for that special look of elegance and style in your kitchen or bathroom. Find it at Conet Bahamas. Visit any one of our four locations, Freeport, Nassau, Abaco, or Eleuthera, and check out the Casablanca all-white shaker cabinets. You dream it, we design it, we deliver it.
They say that when it hits you, it hits you. A feeling so strong that it's impossible not to give in to. A juicy piece of KFC to feel elevated by the aroma and to free fall into its exciting flavor. Some call it love, attraction, desire. We call it KFC. Ignite your senses with KFC.
Good day, everybody. My name is Deandra Dean from Alive, and I just want to give a happy Mother's Day shout out to my mother, Garnell Dean. Mom, I love you. Thank you for being so supportive, caring, and my number one best friend. I hope you have a wonderful Mother's Day. Mwah.
You're watching Our News on this Mother's Day. Welcome back. Campuses across the country could see a 100% return to in-person learning in the coming weeks, as the Ministry of Health and Wellness has finally given the green light for face-to-face learning. Even as the current academic year is winding down, Education Minister Glenys Hannah-Martin saying the next step is to begin consultation with the unions to get all students back in the classroom as soon as possible.
So we expect, should conditions persist as we see them now, prevail in terms of the positivity of reduction of cases, that we will have full 100% of face-to-face in our schools.
And as for graduation ceremonies, here are the latest protocols.
Every school is going to be doing whatever, you know, they make doing their own thing. They have the autonomy of doing that. But they'll have to comply with protocols. It's not necessarily drive-by. Some will do drive-by, so others will not.
Noting that some students have faced challenges during the pandemic, including simply finding virtual learning difficult or issues accessing the learning platform. Minister Hannah Martin says those students will no longer have to suffer. She says she is proud to say that this year, the ministry will celebrate all students in spite of their academic performances.
There are going to be some children who are not going to be able to meet the criteria for whatever reasons. And they don't usually participate in the end of their school life ceremony. And this year, we're not doing that. We're going to bring all of our young people together. They're going to mark the end of their school life, the 12 years they've been in school. They will do it with their peers. Hopefully, they will do it with a sense of hope for tomorrow, whether they get the high school diploma or not. Because our role is to see how to build our young people, build their esteem, build their confidence, build their skill set so they're able to go out there and be all they can be.
Studies have proven a learning gap brought on by the pandemic, something she says her ministry has been working to close. Hannah Martin also foreshadowing the announcement of partnership that will soon come.
That will be in conjunction with BTVI, with Urban Renewal, and we hope to see this roll out in the summer for young people. The other thing is that there is an RFP currently published, which is inviting proposals for a consultant to assist us in standardizing diagnostics and designing an acceleration learning program age appropriate. So that's where we are now. We're doing all that we can. This was a curveball in terms of education globally.
FNM Chairman Dr. Dwayne Sands giving the Progressive Liberal Party a D-plus grade average for its first 8 months in office. Dr. Sands saying that he believes it's an objective score that reflects the positive and negative of the government's performance thus far.
I would give them, a D-plus. They have had their successes and they have had their challenges. The problem is that their challenges have outweighed their successes. And I believe this administration is rapidly squandering a lot of goodwill.
Dr. Sand says some of the government's low points include controversial comments made by ministers and a headline this week that revealed that some MPs didn't know they had to make financial disclosures.
This week's or yesterday's headline is not a good look. The challenges that they've had with ministers speaking out of turn, not a good look. They have had enough problems that it's almost time for them to go into retreat and regroup.
When our news comes back from the break, Bahamas National Trust Chief gets ready to pass on the baton. Plus, reigning MVP Jonquel Jones gets her season started. And later, do you have what it takes? A behind-the-scenes look at our news casting call.
Happy Foods. Happy Foods. 242. 242. Happy Foods. 242. Food galore just for you. Happy Foods. 242. Galore just for you. This ain't no talking show, it's an eating show. Sasha Lorel is the host of Happy Foods. 242, food galore just for you. Happy Foods. 242, food galore.
It's Philly cheesesteak time at Burger King Nassau. This classic sandwich isn't just a Philly cheesesteak, it's a Burger King Philly cheesesteak. Enjoy your sandwich with flame-grilled beef, plant-based, or try the crispy chicken version with all the Philly fixins, including lots of melted cheese, caramelized onions, bell peppers, and mushrooms on a sesame seed hoagie bun. Visit any of Burger King Nassau's 7 locations and enjoy your Philly cheesesteak as a combo or as part of the King's Feast at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Not part hard to get, you know.
Unless you go to WimAuto.com.
Man, anybody get our website, man. How you know that's the right part?
On WimAuto.com, you can enter the year, make, model, and engine size of your vehicle, and choose the part that you need.
This is a Japanese car.
You can shop for that on our website.
What about chemicals?
Yep.
Car accessories?
Yep.
Tools?
Actually, yeah.
Plumbing, electrical, and grocery?
If we sell it, it's on our website. Don't worry, we don't have mechanics.
Oh, thank goodness.
Save time and shop with confidence with WimAuto.com.
Comfort Suites Paradise Island is the best-kept secret in the Bahamas. Located directly next door to the Atlantis Resort, you'll receive all the privileges of an Atlantis guest with all the benefits of a Comfort Suite stay. Enjoy everything Atlantis has to offer, including Aquaventure Water Park, plus all the amenities of Comfort Suites. Free Wi-Fi, free breakfast daily, and kids stay, play, and eat free. Visit ComfortSuitesPI.com.
This is our News Weekend Edition. Welcome back. In just over 6 months, Bahamas National Trust Executive Director Eric Carey will step down from the post he has held for nearly 2 decades. In this report from our Jasmine Brown, Carey explains what prompted his decision.
For the last 20 years, Eric Carey has left his mark here at the Bahamas National Trust, where he's addressed environmental issues head on, and he and his team have ensured that national parks and protected areas were established.
I think we're in a position where we can bring in leadership that myself and the board can support. We're at the top of our game. We're doing well. There's always a need for more funding, but donors are, and people are, warming up to the BNT lending support. So it's time to hand the baton, but we're going to do it in a 4-by-1.
Eric Carey has been the public face of the Bahamas National Trust, never shying away from addressing environmental issues head on. But last month, the Bahamas National Trust announced that Carey will step down as executive director on December 31st, 2022.
My vision has always been to return to Eleuthera. I'm an island boy. I'm from Tarpon Bay. They tell us, we're a drinking village with a fishing problem. So I intend to go back to Tarpon Bay to have a few and to catch a few.
During his tenure, Carey has achieved a lot, including helping raise over $60 million and helping the organization increase staff from a dozen to nearly 100 employees. But one of the biggest achievements for Carey is helping to develop an expansive national park system.
We've been able to bring the BNT into something that Bahamians identify with, that they support, that they understand what we do. We manage national parks for you. These are your spaces. And that, for me, is the most satisfying thing that I have gotten out of it. And seeing Bahamians in their parks, to me, gives me the greatest sense of achievement.
As for what he would like to see the next BNT executive director take on,
continue to build a relationship and a trust with the government. At the same time, be prepared to engage the government in difficult conversations. We are mandated to offer government advice on matters that pertain to the environment. So, and we have to be prepared to offer that advice without fear of having funding cut or whatever. I mean, we just have to do our job.
While Carey's departure is still months away, the BNT Council has said it initiated a formal process to identify a new executive director. Reporting for our news, I'm Jasmine Brown.
Reigning MVP Jonquel Jones getting her season started as Jazz Chisholm helps power the Marlins to a win. Marcellus Hall is up now with sports.
Welcome to All Sports, everybody. I'm Marcellus Hall.
Grand Bahama Native Jonquel Jones and her Connecticut son kicking off their WNBA season yesterday, taking on the New York Liberty. Jones, of course, coming off an MVP season, looking to capitalize with a win as she and her team on the road to start the season. Things didn't quite go as planned. They trailed. They actually led it the first quarter, 19-12, but couldn't hold on as New York Liberty kicked it in. They would actually outscore the Sun 26-11 in the second quarter, and they would never look back. They go on to win in a close one, 81-79. Jones and crew kind of making a game of it, just couldn't quite get there. As for that, they had start the season off 0-1. As for Jones, she played 32 minutes, finished up with 15 points to go along with 7 rebounds, 2 assists, and a couple of block shots. So all in all, a good game for her. They're hoping to bounce back with a win as the season continues. Right now, their next game will come your way a little bit later on this week. The next game actually comes on Saturday. They play again next week Saturday when they take on the L.A. Sparks. They'll be hosting the L.A. Sparks at home. Meanwhile, let's take a look and see how Jazz Chisholm season is continuing. He and the Miami Marlins in action on the weekend as well, playing a 3-game set, taking a look at their activities. As yesterday, Jazz and the crew trying to pick up another win, trying to get back on the winning track, going up against the San Diego Padres. And this one on the road. And how about Jazz and the Marlins? They get a nice win here. 8-0 ends up being the final score. Jazz would contribute. He went 1-for-5 with a double, his 6th on the season. Also picked up an RBI in the process. All in all, good day for the Marlins. They pick up a nice win. They, too, will be back in action again this week. In fact, they play again today when they take on the very same San Diego Padres. I'll give you details on that one coming up for you tomorrow. Marlins right now on a win streak, a one-game win streak. They're trying to get back on track at 13-14, second in the National League East.
That's the first grand slam for Soler.
Hi, my name is Kieran Chase, Senior Product Manager on Alive's commercial team. Just want to give a quick and very special shout out to my mother. She's always been there for me and continues to be a foundational part of my support system. So I'm grateful for that. And, you know, of course, a happy Mother's Day to mothers all across the Bahamas and beyond.
The free testing this weekend in Clinic Care's health fair, plus a behind-the-scenes look at what our news casting call this weekend looks like. That's coming up when our news returns.
We plan for where we are today. A strong company. A powerful network. Built by the people, for the people. Because we believed in best. Because we lived for the moments. And we delivered. You know what we were. Now, you get to see who we are. We are Alive.
When you combine decadence, luxury, passion, and attention to detail, you've described Café Chani Noël and Patisserie, signature authentic French macarons, croissants, pastries for breakfast and lunch will take you on a European Epicurean journey. Enjoy your favorite handcrafted cocktails, coffees, cappuccinos, espressos, and lattes. Life is sweet at Café Chani Noël.
Almost every journey starts with your car. We spend most of the early stages of our lives anticipating getting our first set of wheels. When that moment finally comes, let AID be there for all your auto needs. Make it yours by accessorizing, maintaining, and repairing your car with AID. Whether you're a professional mechanic, a recent graduate, a full-time mom, or an I can fix that kind of guy. Or if you're completely clueless about what your car needs, AID will assist in providing a large variety of auto parts, a diagnostic center, and great customer service. For all life's auto journeys, we're here. AID, all you really need and more.
Welcome back to our News Weekend Edition. Clinic Care Women's Diagnostic and Reproductive Center bringing free health care to families in the inner city this weekend. General practitioner Dr. Jacqueline Penold says her practice has been in the Marathon area for 5 years now and considers her community family. The clinic partnering with a number of pharmacies and medical organizations to host the Family Health Fair.
They're all dealing with different areas. We have diabetes, we have persons talking about diabetic foot, we have persons talking about hypertension, we have hypertensive meds, we have persons talking about, a treat for the kids. We have Dairy Queen who just wanted to just come and give the kids a little treat. So outside, basically, we have persons who are just dealing with that. Blood pressure check, cholesterol check.
May is observed as Mental Health Awareness Month, and services at the fair also providing attendees with some helpful information.
During COVID, a lot of our people had a problem with just being closed in and the whole COVID situation at the time. And out of that, we had a lot of mental health. issues that came out of it. We have Hillcrest, which is one of the booths here, and one of the physicians there deal with mental health. And so we wanted to make people more aware that they're not the only ones suffering from mental health at this time, but kind of educate them about what's going on with mental health.
And time now for a look at your weekend and 5-day weather forecast. Our TV team is expanding, and we're bringing on the best and the brightest in the business to educate, entertain, and inform you. We saw some rising stars who came in ready to prove why they should be on national TV. Our Jean Joseph has a behind-the-scenes look at the auditions and a glimpse of the future.
We got a chance to see some aspiring on-air personalities during the last phase of our casting call, a first for the company, and part of a recruitment exercise as RTV gets set to bring you a wider variety of programming. 13 applicants were invited to an in-person casting call at the RTV studios, beating out a field of just over 60 persons. The finalists were judged based on their on-camera presence, personality, and overall presentation. They came prepared to showcase their skills and hopefully get one step closer to being on national TV. Sturmon Roll, a past member of the Youth Zone, says being on television was his childhood dream, and when he saw the ad, he decided to try out and see how far he could get. Roll shared his thoughts about the auditions.
I feel pretty excited. One of the things that I just said, I'm just gonna do my best, have fun with it, like just enjoy the experience above all else, like not be so critical and so putting so much pressure on myself that, you know, it's an audition, but like just enjoy it. So I'm excited.
The finalists, many with communications related degrees, came from a diverse range of backgrounds. Marlena Leonard, a writer and producer with experience in front of and behind the camera, says she is excited about the opportunity to bring some of her skills to the table.
I intend to bring that to our news. I intend to bring that to this country. A lot of people say that you can't do these things down here, and I think they're kind of forgetting to add the yet to the end of it. And it's just important to have people here who are willing to kind of grind through the growing process to make sure that other people can have it later.
Tage Adderley also shared his experience and his feelings about the audition.
And podcasting and a little bit of broadcasting, and then I've done a lot of writing and producing. So it's going to be cool to get on the other side of things. I've done a lot of behind the scenes things, and I have done a lot of audio, not too much video. So we'll see how it goes.
RTV will continue to seek out new and undiscovered talent. So create, and be on the lookout for the next round of auditions, because it may be your time. I'm Jean Joseph, reporting for Our News.
And we would like to send a special thank you to Christine Bullard at Gardenia Celebrations for the beautiful floral arrangement you've seen on set tonight, all in celebration of our mothers this Mother's Day. And thank you for joining us for Our News Weekend Edition. On behalf of the entire team, I'm Megan Shepherd. Have a safe and wonderful evening.